The report, which has been released and handed over to Parliament, dubbed Squeezing Water Out of Stone, has revealed that 70% of the police officers in the Uganda Police Force reported unfairness in deployments and promotions. They attributed unfairness to corruption and other related underhand methods.
Personnel had to individually foot the cost of their relocation, regardless of the process or factors for deployment or transfer.
The research conducted in 2022 also revealed that police officers are living in extremely unimaginable, deplorable living conditions, where some officers are accommodated in compromising rooms that are only separated by curtains and lack privacy to exercise their conjugal rights.
Junior personnel were the most disadvantaged in terms of acquiring decent housing, as they were often displaced from institutional accommodation by their bosses. Some personnel opted to live in their own homes or voluntarily rent outside institutional accommodation.
Wangadia added that many police officers lived between 3 to 8 kilometers away from their workstations, while 3% lived more than 8 kilometers away, even up to 14 kilometers, because they were displaced from the barracks by senior personnel.
The force does not facilitate their staff with organized transport to and from work, yet they are on call 24/7. The linkage between the living and working conditions of the police force personnel and their observance of human rights of others came out evidently. This explains the choice of our title, Squeezing Water Out of a Stone.
The report has also revealed that police personnel have reached an extent of using their own money to do police work, because a number of police personnel receive insufficient or no interest at all.
They resort to doing less, but within their means. At times, they have to share guns, ask complainants to transport officers, use wananchi to carry accident victims, use ropes in lieu of handcuffs, walk with suspects to court in the absence of vehicles, and use observation to detect crime in lieu of required gadgets, among others. Nevertheless, some of their strategies were found to be high risk.
Wangadia made the remarks while handing over a report to the Deputy Speaker of Parliament on the research conducted on the welfare of Uganda Police Force. She defended the title of the research paper, Squeezing Water Out of Stone, arguing that Uganda's police personnel were giving a lot more than they earn.
Personnel are giving a lot more than they are receiving. And in some instances, it is amazing how, in their given conditions, they can still manage to provide any service.
The Deputy Speaker, Tayewa, thanked police officers for continuing to work despite the challenges they are facing and called for a deeper study on the impact of the silence of the police officers.
This is what it takes. That's why the spirit of nationalism, the spirit of patriotism comes in there. That doesn't mean they shouldn't be demanding for these services. No, they should be demanding for them. But I really want to thank them. No one has stopped work because they don't have housing. But now we have to go and study. What is the impact?
Tayewa tasked the government to further establish why more Ugandans are fighting to join the force despite the current challenges faced by the force.
An advert, I've received over 100 calls. Help me, I join police. Okay? Even the ones who are appearing before professional standards, when they are being told we can chase you, they are begging, we don't want to go, despite the hard working condition. So is there another driving factor? Is it corruption? Are they finding a way of mitigating their situation?
Meanwhile, in a joint partnership with the Uganda Police Force, the Human Rights Commission launched a report at the Commission's headquarters in Kampala.
The Uganda Police Force have the honor to launch a report on whose theme is Squeezing Water Out of a Stone.
Assistant Inspector General of Police Erasmus Torohuka, working in the Uganda Police Force Legal Department, acknowledged the report findings and urged the recommendations to be put in black and white so that they are keenly implemented.
So that at the end of the day, we shall witness a situation where the working uneven conditions of police personnel impact the observance of human rights positively.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi and Derek Asaba for the news.